Have you ever wondered how cruise ships went from these small, cozy vessels to the giant floating cities we see today? A few decades ago, the thought of a 1,000-passenger cruise was considered huge, but now some of these ships carry over 9,000 people. Hold on tight, because in today's video, we're about to uncover the mind-blowing secrets behind how cruise ships turned into floating giants. From groundbreaking engineering to the race for ultimate luxury. So stay tuned and keep watching our channel, The Curious Corner. Believe it or not, the first modern cruise ship wasn't about luxury. It was all about getting from point A to point B. Back in the early 1900s, cruise ships were the height of luxury, primarily used for transatlantic travel. Think the iconic RMS Titanic, crossing the vast ocean with style and grandeur. But what if I told you the real transformation didn't happen until the 1950s? After World War II, the world was ready for something new, and that's when luxury cruises began to evolve into what we know today. But here's the catch. Back then, these ships were small, really small, often carrying no more than 500 passengers. The idea was simple. Offer a smooth, comfortable journey across the sea where passengers could enjoy the finest luxuries on board. But as the years passed, something shifted. Comfort alone wasn't going to cut it anymore. For centuries, nations like the UK, US and other maritime European nations were at the forefront of exploration, trade, and naval power. This connection to the ocean shaped their identity, and luxury cruises became a natural extension of that maritime love. For many, the ocean symbolizes freedom, adventure, and escape. Therefore, as competition in the travel industry heated up, cruise lines had to step up their game. The question was no longer just, how do we make the journey more luxurious? It became, how do we make the voyage unforgettable? Cruise lines started to realize bigger was better. With the boom in post-war travel and the rise of disposable income, the demand for luxury cruises skyrocketed. People wanted more, more space, more amenities, more luxury. The cruise industry went from small ships like the Queen Mary to floating resorts. And by the late 1980s, ships were carrying 2,000 to 3,000 passengers, offering swimming pools, movie theaters, nightclubs, and restaurants. Ships were no longer just transportation. They were destinations in themselves. And then, the Oasis of the Seas, launched by Royal Caribbean in 2009, changed the game. Twice the size of any cruise ship before it, with a capacity of 6,300 passengers, it was the largest ship in the world at the time, which had a construction cost of about $1.4 billion. So, why did cruise lines suddenly start building mega ships like this? The rise of mega cruise ships can be traced back to several key factors, such as advancements in technology, which allowed ships to be built bigger, faster, and more efficient. Stronger hulls and sophisticated navigation systems allowed these ships to handle the weight of thousands of passengers. But the most important factor was, the cruise lines realized they could make more money per passenger with bigger ships. For the luxury suites, prices could go as high as $5,000 to $6,000 per person. It was 5 to 12 times more revenue per passenger than the average ticket on smaller ships. More passengers mean more restaurants, more activities, more entertainment, and a larger market share for cruise lines. This led to ships with roller coasters, ice skating rinks, water parks, and even Broadway-style theaters. Larger ships can offer a variety of experiences that smaller ships just can't. Having multiple pools, diverse restaurants, and entertainment options all within arm's reach. And it's not just about luxury. Bigger ships can also offer cheaper options for budget travelers while still delivering top-tier experiences. For some, it's about the thrill of having everything in one place, a mini city on the water. For others, it's the affordable luxury that allows them to travel in style without breaking the bank. Over time, major innovations in cruise ships were made. Ships now use reverse osmosis or multi-stage flash distillation to turn seawater into potable drinking water, being more self-sufficient and reducing their reliance on shore facilities. This technology is critical, especially on mega cruise ships, as they carry thousands of people and need vast amounts of fresh water. Air lubrication systems were also introduced, which reduced friction between the hull and the water, making the ship more fuel efficient. Cruise lines started incorporating LNG to power ships, which reduces harmful emissions like sulfur and carbon dioxide, making ships more environmentally friendly. Solar panels and kite-assisted propulsion help reduce fuel consumption and emissions. And the advanced waste management systems was introduced that turn waste into usable energy or biodegradable products, ensuring that cruise ships comply with stricter environmental regulations. Currently, modern ships use facial recognition technology and AI-powered concierge services to enhance passenger experience, reducing the need for traditional check-ins and speeding up the boarding process, offering personalized recommendations for dining, activities, and excursions. So, what does the future hold for cruise ships? If you think they've reached their maximum size, think again. Cruise lines are already working on even bigger and more innovative ships, using sustainable technology like solar-powered vessels and designs to minimize environmental impact. In the next decade, we could be seeing ships with artificial intelligence, self-sustaining ecosystems, and space for even more passengers. The cruise industry isn't slowing down. If anything, it's just getting started. Thank you so much for watching. Please like and subscribe our channel, The Curious Corner, for more fascinating content.